Allahu, 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 Allah, Allahu, 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 Allah.
Inna alhamda lillahi nahmaduhu wa nasta'inuhu wa nastaghfiruhu wa nastahdih. Wa na'udhu billahi min shururi anfusina wa min sayyiati a'malina. Man yahdihillahu fala mudilla lahu wa man yudlil fala hadiya lahu. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده وحبيبه ورسوله صلوات الله وسلامه عليه وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين وتابعين لهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين أوصيكم بتقوى الله عز وجل فقد قال عز وجل في كتابه الكريم يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون فقد قال مصطفى صلى الله عليه وسلم عليكم بسنتي وسنة خلفاء الراشدين المهديين من بعدي عضوا عليها بالنواجذ وعليكم والمحدثات الأمور فإن كل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة وكل ضلالة في النار ثم أما بعد يا عباد الله Today I'm going to talk about one of the biggest sins in Islam, about one of the seven major sins in Islam, about the topic, it is actual in these days, about killing innocent people. And Allah's Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, اجتنبوا سبع موبقات ثم ذكر قتل نفسي التي حرم الله إلا بالحق رواه البخاري ومسلم. Stay away from the seven of major sins. Then Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he mentioned killing innocent people, and this hadith is recorded in the book of Bukhari and Muslim. The real size of that sin we can see in hadith where the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, أول ما يقضى بين الناس يوم القيامة في الدماء متفق عليه. The Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said in this hadith, first, for what we are going to be judged on the day of the judgment is the innocent blood, the blood of the innocent people. How are we going to be judged for the blood of innocent people at the judgment day? The explanation of that we have in the Quran, in Surah Al-Ma'idah, when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, مَنْ قَتَلَ نَفْسًا بِغَيْرِ نَفْسٍ أَوْ فَسَادٍ فِي الْأَرْضِ فَكَأَنَّمَا قَتَلَ النَّاسَ جَمِيعًا وَمَنْ أَحْيَاهَا فَكَأَنَّمَا أَحْيَا النَّاسَ جَمِيعًا. Who killed or who kills one innocent man, it is like he killed all the people on the earth. And who save one innocent life, it is like he saved the lives of all the people in the world. But what is the meaning of this ayah in Quran? One of the famous comments of Quran, Imam At-Tabari, he mentioned in comment of this ayah, the meaning of this ayah is that who kill one innocent person in this world, in the judgment day, he will get punishment. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will punish him like he killed all the people in the world. He killed one person, but he will get punishment like he killed all the person in the world. So imagine that. Who kill one person, innocent person, on the judgment day, he will get punishment like he killed 7 billion men, 7 billion people, they are living now on this earth. This is the meaning of this ayah. And who save one innocent life, he will get the prize on judgment day from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will reward him judgment day like he saved the lives of all the people in the world. So the innocent, when we say and when we mention the innocent people, we say innocent people, we mean innocent Muslims and innocent non-Muslims. Innocent Muslims and innocent non-Muslims. You don't have right to kill innocent people. He is Muslim or non-Muslim. And Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he mentioned that in hadith. In hadith is recorded in the book of Bukhari. Man qatala mu'ahidan lam yarih ra'ihat al-jannah. Rawahu al-Bukhari. Who killed al-mu'ahid, he will not be able to feel the smell of the paradise. He will not feel the smell of the paradise. In the other version of this hadith, in the book of Nasa'i, Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Mana Allahu alayhi al-jannah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will forbid him to entry a paradise. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will forbid him to enter the paradise. Who kill mu'ahid. And who is the mu'ahid? Ibn Hajar al-Asqalani, one of the biggest Islamic scholars, one of the famous Islamic scholars in history of Islam, he say, al-mu'ahid is non-Muslim. He's not Muslim. But he came in Muslim country by the contract with government, with Muslim government, or with by the contract with one of the Muslim, he is the citizen of this Muslim country. He guarantee him that nobody is not going to kill him or hurt him in Muslim country. So non-Muslim, kafir, came in Muslim country, in our country, with the contract. Islamic government gave him a visa, or he came with the guarantee of one of the Muslim from that country, Muslim country, and nobody has not right to kill him. If he kill him, Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam say he will not be able to smell or to feel the smell of the paradise, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will forbid him to entry the paradise. And this hadith is very clear. And this is not my words. This is the words of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And the comment of this hadith is from Ibn Hajar al-Asqalani, rahmatullahi ta'ala alayhi. Ordinary, if someone intend to commit one of the sin, and after that he doesn't commit this sin, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will not punish him about this intention in his heart. He intends to do some sin, but it is not the case with the killing innocent people. If someone intend If someone intends to kill any innocent person in the world, and after that he was not able to do that, he doesn't commit that sin, even after that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will punish him because of this intention in his heart, because of the niyyah in his heart. He didn't do it. He had a niyyah to kill someone. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will punish him because of that niyyah. Where is the evidence? Where is the proof in hadith where the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, إِذَا الْتَقَى الْمُسْلِمَانِ بِسَيْفِهِمَا فَالْقَاتِلْ وَالْمَقْتُولْ فِي النَّارِ رَوَاهُ الْبُخَارِي وَالْمُسْلِمِ. If two Muslims meet each other with their weapons and then they fight each other, the killer will go to the hell. And the other, he was killed, he will go to the hell. Strange. And it was the strange for Sahaba, for the friends of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And they asked him, okay, we understand why the killer is going to the hell. It's clear. But why this, the other one, he got killed, why he will go to the hell? And Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said, because he has a niyyah, he has an intention in his heart to kill the other one. But the other one was better in using weapon and he killed him the first. But the other one, he was killed, he will go to the hell because he has a niyyah in his heart to kill the other one. But who are these Muslims today? They are allow killing innocent people. Innocent Muslim and innocent non-Muslims. Who are they? They are the sects. A firqa, min al-firq al-islamiyya, known by the name al-khawarij, the first sect in Islam, and one of the most dangerous sects in Islam. One of their characteristics, how the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam described them, is they are killing innocent people. They are killing innocent people. They killed a lot of famous friends of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. They killed Uthman radiallahu ta'ala an. He was the husband of two daughters of Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. They killed Ali radiallahu ta'ala an, the husband of Fatima, the daughter of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. They killed Zubayr ibn al-Awam radiallahu ta'ala an. They killed Talha radiallahu ta'ala an. All of them, Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam promised them that they will go to the paradise, and they were alive, and they killed them. They want to take our mother Aisha radiallahu ta'ala anha, the person that Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam loved her more than anybody else in the world when she was and he was alive. They want to take her like a slave. The sects called Al-Khawarij, if we translate, we can say extremist, terrorist. The Al-Khawarij. They are the first Muslims, Muslim sect. They allow to kill women and the children. When they kidnapped the son of the friend of Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the son of Habab ibn Arat radiallahu ta'ala an, Abdullah ibn Habab ibn Arat, and he was with his wife, with his pregnant wife. They slaughter Abdullah ibn Habab ibn Arat rahmatullahi ta'ala alayhi. After they slaughter him, they slaughter his wife, the pregnant wife. And that was not enough for them. They cut her stomach, they took out a baby, and they slaughtered the baby. These sects are the terrorists, a real extremist. This is their characteristic. They allow killing innocent people. And because of that, Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam called them Al-Khawariju Kilabun Nari. Al-Khawariju Kilabun Nari. Rawahu Imam Ahmad wa Ibn Majah wa sahahahu Shaykh Al-Albani. This hadith is recorded in the book of Ahmad and in the book of Nasa'i. Rahmatullahi alayhima. And at the end, who give you permission to kill yourself? To do suicide? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala very clearly said in Quran, in Surah An-Nisa, وَلَا تَقْتُلُوا أَنفُسَكُمْ. Don't kill yourself. And Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said in hadith recorded in the book of Bukhari and Muslim, مَنْ قَتَلَ نَفْسَهُ بِشَيْءٍ عُذِّبَ بِهِ فِي نَارِ جَهَنَّمْ. Who killed himself with something in this world, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will punish him by throwing him in the Jahannam, in the hell, and his punishment will be that he is going to kill himself all the time in the hell, same way like he killed himself in this world. And this hadith is recorded in the book of Bukhari and Muslim. Barakallahu li wa lakum في الكتاب العظيم ونفعني وإياكم بما فيه من آيات الكريم فاستغفر الله لي ولكم فاستغفره إنه هو الغفور الرحيم. بسم الله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله ثم أما بعد. Dear brothers and sisters in Islam, killing innocent Muslims in Syria, in Palestine, in Myanmar, in Iraq, in Afghanistan is the crime according to Sharia law, according our religion Islam. It is a crime. Killing innocent people in Paris, in Brussels is also the crime according Sharia law. So, dear brother and dear sister in Islam, you have to choose between two options. Between two options. First option is what Quran says about killing innocent people. And what Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam says about killing innocent people. This is the first choice. And the second choice is what the sects calling Al-Khawarij says about killing innocent people. Quran say that this is forbidden, this is haram in Islam, killing innocent people. And Khawarij say it is good, it's good deed to kill innocent people. Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam say, he says that everyone who kill innocent people, he will go to the hell. And the dogs of the hell, kilab, dogs of the hell, they say no, they will go to the paradise. Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he say they will be the dogs in the hell, and extremist al-khawarij, they say no, who kill himself and the other innocent people around him, he will go straight in the paradise without judgment day, without be judged at the judgment day. And he will get 70 of the paradise virgins. Allahumma sta'an. Allahumma sta'an. So the choice is yours. You have to choose what Quran and what Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, or what the Al-Khawarij says. But remember, you have only one life in this world. You have only one chance. You will not be able to choose twice. There is no second chance. So be careful what you are going to choose. Inna Allah wa malaikatahu yusalluna ala an-nabi. يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما. اللهم صلي وسلم وبارك على سيد الأولين والآخرين وعلى إمام المرسلين نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. وارض اللهم عن خلفاء أربعة أبي بكر الصديق.
الله الله الله.